So a lot of us are occupied in looking at this, and one of the interesting things about cities is it covers a whole wealth of disciplines. So you've been speaking to people here in the London School of Economics and the Cities branch. It involves economists, it involves technologists, engineers, scientists and politicians. Because without collaboration and something close to a common understanding of some of the key issues, some of the key challenges, it's very difficult to try and figure out how we can innovate our way out of this. Cisco's a company I advise. It's working very actively in connected urban development to try and bring about sustainable cities through innovation. But it does this in a number of areas. It could be through transport, it could be through smart grids and smart building. It could just be through better monitoring and management of data, for example. That could be locally, the amount of the degree to which my fridge talks to my heating, talks to my phone and knows when I'm in. Or it could be done globally through large-scale global Earth observation, a project that Cisco has been undertaking with NASA called Planetary Skim, so that we can monitor resources on the planet's surface, carbon emissions, tree cover, water management. Much easier to manage and anticipate and reduce your vulnerabilities to problems if you can monitor what's going on and do so in as close to real time. So that's something that technology can offer, and that's something that technologists working closely with governments and with engineers and with policymakers can do to bring about more resource-efficient cities. But it also requires an understanding at a higher level of some of the challenges, both real but also political economic challenges. What are the concerns of businesses in terms of competitiveness? What are, there are energy and carbon-intensive sectors that are worried that they're going to stand to lose on the application of policies that encourage energy efficiency, for example. How do you assuage their concerns? How do you allow politicians to do something to help that transition, to allow those industries to retool to what is inevitably going to be the new industries of tomorrow? So there's a big political element there, and there's a big economic element here. I've said already that some of the benefits of moving towards sustainable resource use in terms of growth are very large, because the very process of becoming more efficient is a process of innovation, and it's innovation that drives growth. But it requires a real in-depth understanding of some of the numbers, a quantitative assessment of what does that actually mean in terms of how much growth might we expect for cities that move faster in becoming, in aiming to become, for example, carbon neutral. We've seen these qualitative examples, but it'd be nice to get some numbers. What are the health benefits? What are the congestion benefits? How do we weigh these up? And we're undertaking something called the Stern Cities Project at the moment, working with Lord Stern, the author of the Stern Review on Climate Change, to see if we can say something a little bit more specific on the numbers that are involved there. Very difficult to do, as I've said already, no two cities are identical, so you can't ever say something with deterministic precision, but you can begin to show similar cities in different countries that have taken different policy paths and have reduced their resource intensity and say something about their evolution, the degree to which they're economically, socially and environmentally successful places to live in. And if there are examples of cities that haven't managed that transition terribly well, what can we learn from that? So it's a fascinating area, and ultimately I think unless you address the role of cities in using resources, when you've got urbanization taking place at the pace it is in countries like India and China, where cities the size of Manhattan or New York actually are urbanization is taking place at the rate of a New York a year or whatever the statistic is, there's no way that you can hope to address some of the global challenges if those cities are not locking into the right kind of processes, the right institutions and the right infrastructure now. So time is not on our side in this respect, but it also makes it a very important and very exciting area to work in.